The SMQ Weather Application illustrates how a web-based user interface can be synchronized with the user interface in a device. The SMQ Weather Application consists of three parts: the server application, the thermostat device, and the browser user interface. Start by downloading the simulated thermostat device for Windows. Run the self-extracting archive and unpack it to any directory. The simulated thermostat device should start as soon as the self-extracting archive completes packing up the files. To synchronize a web interface with a device, click the menu button and then click the Start Browser button. A browser window should then open and synchronize with the device. You can also manually synchronize a browser user interface by simply navigating to the online thermostat user interface, clicking the menu button, clicking Connect, and then enter the device key in the browser. You may synchronize any number of web user interfaces with the device. We are connecting a second browser window to show you how all synchronized user interfaces are updated in real time at the same time. This figure illustrates the messaging between the device and the two browser windows. All communication goes via the SMQ broker running in the server. The two browser windows are shown at the top. The simulated device and the two browser windows connect to the online IoT server solution. The weather application also consists of a dedicated server-side application implemented in the Lua scripting language. The server-side weather application is in charge of creating a dedicated connection island for each connected device. Each connected device can be separately controlled by any number of browsers. The server-side weather application is also responsible for connecting to third-party services such as IP address to geolocation service and a weather database. These third-party services can be accessed by using HTTP and REST. Note that the weather database used is Open Weather Map. This service can be slow and does not always return correct results. Note that clicking the thermostat plus minus button in any of the synchronized user interfaces is automatically replicated to all other connected user interfaces, including the device. Let's go ahead and change the location to the North Pole. When you click the Submit button, a message is sent to the server-side weather application, which in turn queries the weather database. When the weather database responds, the server-side weather application relays this data to the device and all connected browsers. Let's change the location to a city where it is currently raining. Notice how all user interfaces are updated as soon as the weather database responds. All user interfaces receive the current weather and a 7-day forecast. When you close a browser interface, the server-side weather application is notified via the SMQ broker. The browser's connection ID is then removed from the connection island. Notice what happens in the browser when we terminate the device. The thermostat is removed since we are no longer connected to a device. When a device terminates or disconnects, the connection island associated with this device is terminated in the server application. We have so far given you the impression that there is only one online server. There are in fact four online servers and four public IP addresses associated with a domain name simplemq.com. This is known as Round Robin DNS. The SMQ server application is configured as a cluster, where each cluster node is connected to all other nodes. We have configured the DNS server such that you can navigate to a specific cluster node by entering the cluster node name followed by the domain name, simplemq.com. For example, to navigate to cluster node 2, enter node2.simplemq.com in the browser. Let's go ahead and synchronize the two browser windows with the device by entering the device key in the two browser windows. Notice that the browser window 1 is connected to cluster node 1 and browser window 2 is connected to cluster node 2. We do not know what cluster node the device is connected to since the device connects to simplemq.com. The DNS for this domain resolves to 4 IP addresses and the device selects one of the 4 IP addresses. Clustering enables us to scale a server solution horizontally. Clustering also provides redundancy. A browser user may wish to synchronize with a particular device. However, the browser may not be connected to the same cluster node as the device. The SMQ Cluster plugin provides a server-side API that enables server-side code to automatically redirect a connection to another cluster. This redirection request is permanent. When Browser 1 sends a synchronization request by sending the device key to the server-side weather application in cluster node 1. The server-side weather application redirects the synchronization request to cluster node 3. The SMQ cluster plugin now takes care of redirecting all future communication between browser 1 and the device.